Up YouTube. Today I'm going to give you all a tutorial on how I do how I draw my dragon scales. There's a tutorial on how I colored them in, and next week I should be doing a tutorial on how I made the belly of the dragon. Okay, let's get started. Let me get this up here so y'all guys can get a closer view. Already I put some down, but I'm going to show you how I usually draw my bodies of dragons or snakes. I usually use a French curve. If you don't got one of these, you should get one if you're learning how to get into art, because you really can use it in so many ways. You find the use for it. So let's start off with the dragon scales. Let me zoom in for you guys. Let's just draw a body again. Let's see if you can see. Now I'm using a chalk pencil because it has no reflection, and y'all guys will get a better view. When I use the HB, I really don't get that good of it. Don't look that good on the video. You really can't see it too good. So I'm going to show y'all guys how I draw it, and it's easier for y'all to see the chalk because there's no reflection. Okay, let's the biggest thing about drawing dragon scales is when you first start off. It's so easy to draw dragon scales. All you have to do is what I show you right here. First off, I always start off in the middle. Start off with a half a circle. That's all you do, half a circle. Do the same thing on your next one. Try to make it the same height. Right there's another one. And this is the biggest part right now, what I'm about to do on how you make dragon scales. Let me zoom in. See the circle? Find the middle of the circle and start drawing it, and I want you to meet up to the next middle of the circle and do it the same thing on the other side. Meet in the middle of the circle. I make my dragon scales bigger and smaller. To me it looks more realer, more rougher of a dragon, you know. That's what I would think a dragon would look like. And you do the same thing there. At the edge, you don't. You make a half a circle and let it meet. Now, I try to follow the flow of which way the body's going. As you can see, this is going like this. I try to follow the flow with the lines going that way. Let me draw some more for y'all. You know. And now, there's like tons of ways to draw dragon scales. I'm going to show you all like a different way. You can let your mind go wild. As long as you remember, once you draw your first item that you draw, like a circle, a square, whatever it is, you always have to find the middle of it and do another one and find the middle of another circle and meet there. It's not hard at all. That's how you make scales for dragons, snakes, lizards, but where I'm telling you, you can let your mind go wild, like I'll show you, you can even go like this. You can like do a house scale. I call it a house scale. To me, it looks like a house. Once you do one, another one right there, down, down. Now find the edge. Make the middle one. I always make middle first, like I said before. You know, try to get them the same height. Okay. Now here, same thing with the circles. You find the top part, middle, go up, curve, curve, meet in the middle of that. Go up like a house. I think they look like houses. I really like these kind of scales right here. Go up, curve, curve. You know, you can see what I'm trying to show you. Like, as long as you meet in the middle of the next circle you're doing, you can keep going on with it. That looks a little rough, but I'm trying to rush this. Okay, now you can see these right now. If you're not going to put color in these, what I recommend highly is do at each point, like where they meet up, like right here. So let me try to show you. You shade it right here and do it to all of them, all at the back corners. Like, you can even do some, you know, hatching. Now, if I had a HB pencil or a regular wood pencil, that would look a lot better. I'm trying to show y'all guys. And with a chalk pencil, the tip is really thick. It's hard to make it thin when any sharpener. On this, like where I'm talking about the cross hatching, it makes it look really cool. But pretty much you can go out as long as you meet in the middle. You gotta remember these middle parts. You make a circle, find the middle of the top of the circle, draw another half a circle, and meet at the middle of this half circle. See, and it goes on and on and on like that the whole way through. On however long the body is, you can, you know, you can play around and mess around. Now I put my time in this. If y'all guys can subscribe and like the video and tell me what you don't like about it, I would really appreciate it. If I helped you out, guys, help me out. And I'm gonna try to make one more scale for y'all. Make it up like right now, like you can go. Let's like do a more complicated scale. I guess we can call this a star scale. What I'm trying to show, that actually looks really cool. You meet up in the middle. I guess this would probably be really different, but what it all comes down to is you just have to meet up in the middle. As you can see, it like makes a circle and it's strong. Actually, that looks really good. I never did that. That you can honestly play around with that and make it look really cool if you want it. And again, and if you wanted to know what kind of chalk pencil I'm using, it's actually a simple charcoal soft by this company right here. Let me see if I can get the name. Right there. That's the chalk pencils I use when I use them. And if y'all want to see my next tutorial on the dragon belly, to subscribe, and I should be doing it next week. Thank y'all guys for y'all time. And that's it.